So I want to share something pretty special with you. First, I want to explain a few things. It's about my best friend, the best companion you could ever ask for, my dog, Allie. She died the night before Christmas. I had to put her down. She had cancer about 6-7 months ago, and I had to have her front leg removed, and that was pretty heartbreaking. But she actually did pretty good, and she's a therapy dog for the past 5 years, and we actually went back to visiting patients in the hospital, veterans. She's worked at the U.S. Attorney's Office, care centers. You know, she's laid with people in their last hours. She's changed so many lives, including mine, and she was truly a pretty special part of my life. And I had to say goodbye to her the night before Christmas. But it was truly amazing because something truly amazing happened before we put her down. And I believe it was God's way of saying it's going to be all right. But you know, this dog, you know, before she came into my life, I was pretty bitter. I had a hardened heart. You know, I didn't like too many people. But because of her, I was able to go into places and see things. And she had the spirit of love and compassion, which kind of spilt over onto me from, just what a wonderful dog she was. And saying goodbye to her was pretty difficult. I never grieved for anything like I grieved for her. She was pretty special, but I want to show you a couple things.
Hold on.
So, you know, she was a therapy dog for 5 years, and, you know, she's done some amazing things. And that's from the U.S. Attorney's Office. There was one of her cards that we would give out, and it has a saying on the back of it. And if you go down here, she's got a wall here. Just a whole bunch of pictures of her. I have thousands and thousands of pictures of her. She was a little staffy, a little Staffordshire Terrier. And then this just happened the day before Christmas, and it's not even New Year's yet. And I made some like life-size pictures of her because it's easier just looking at her than, you know, when she's gone. But I want to share something else with you before the video starts. So they gave her all these drugs here. So this is an antibiotic, this is a tramadol, and this is a steroid. And each one of these gave her seizures, which was just heartbreaking. You know, I quit giving it to her. And the whole time she was sick after her leg was removed 6 months ago, I started giving her CBD. I changed her whole diet. I started cooking for her. Because I didn't know where she got the cancer from, whether it was from the food, the vaccinations, I don't know, but I quit everything. And I started cooking for her, and I started giving her CBD. And then I made this stuff. It's kind of like a thing they call a Rick Simpson oil. In her last days, the day before Christmas, she was really suffering. And even I had Percocet and morphine that I gave her, and it still didn't touch it. And I gave her some of this. And thank God for this, because it took her pain away. So I just wanted to share that with you, because this is some pretty good medicine. It's a pain reliever. It's this stuff here. Put her into seizures. But, you know, it's just something I want to share with you. So if your dog's in pain or whatever, I would make this stuff. It's not very difficult to make, and it's the best medicine. But that's not what this video is about, okay? But I just wanted to share her life with you because, she was a therapy dog for the past 5 years, and she was the happiest dog. And I really think you're going to enjoy the video on her life. After she had her leg removed, she was pretty depressed for a couple weeks. She wouldn't eat, so I just packed her up and I took her down to Corpus Christi, to the beach, where I know that she loved it down there. And I'll never forget her running down the beach on her leg for the first time, just her head just bopping, like, look at me, daddy. It was pretty cool. And I'll include that video. But anyway, I just wanted to give a short introduction of what this video is about. I really hope you watch the video and you enjoy it. And you see there, that's her little spirit. And boy, I sure miss her. But, you know, she was just a special dog to so many people. So I really hope you enjoy the video. Thanks for watching.
Can't you see I love you? Please don't break my heart in two. That's the hard to do, cause I don't have a wooden heart. And if you say goodbye, then I know that I would cry. Maybe I would die, cause I don't have a wooden heart. There's no strings upon this love of mine. It was always you from the start. Treat me nice, treat me good, treat me like you really should. Cause I'm not made of wood, and I don't have a wooden heart. Use again, soon stay to lay him down. Stay to lay him out. Don't mind shots blast here. Who's it then? Soon stay to lay him out. Stay to lay him out. Don't mind shots blast here. There's no strings upon this love of mine. It was always you from the start. Sei mir gut, sei mir gut, sei mir wie du wirklich sollst. Wie du wirklich sollst, cause I don't have a word.
If I could save time in a bottle, the first thing that I'd like to do is to save every day till eternity passes away, just to spend them with you. If I could make days last forever, if words could make wishes come true, I'd save every day like a treasure, and then again I would spend them with you. But there never seems to be enough time to do the things you want to do once you find them. I've looked around enough to know you're the one I want to go through time with. If I had a box just for wishes and dreams that had never come true, the box would be empty except for the memory of how they were answered by you. But there never seems to be enough time to do the things you want to do once you find them. I've looked around enough to know you're the one I want to go. Thank you.
Kevin, your buddy's here. I think probably Craig is the leader in the world at this point in terms of hospitals with dog programs.
You are ginormous.
Oh, I think the pet therapy program is just immensely important.
Hey.
For patients, families, staff, kind of everybody. It just kind of adds a whole different element to Craig. Makes Craig what Craig is.
It changes people's attitudes, patients' attitudes. They come here because there's hope.
Animals don't care that you can't speak to them. They don't care what you look like. They don't care if you're having a bad hair day. They don't care about any of those things. They just love you and are there with you.
It exists because Craig, before anybody else literally in the country even thought of having a dog in the hospital, were the foreleaders of doing that.
In our program right now, currently we have 52 different animals that are part of our pet therapy program.
I think each of those dogs in their way offers something to patients.
Are you tough and scary?
Patients love little dogs, and so for those patients, we meet that need.
She's a Maltese.
Newfoundlands have the big advantage of being able to walk up to a wheelchair because of their size.
Oh my goodness, your face.
And the patient be able to immediately put their hand on them and relate to this dog. So each of those dogs provides a certain thing. The little tiny dog, Senor, for example, can be put up on the bed and lay there on the bed with the patient if that's what the patient would desire.
What the animals provide for everybody is just key. I think it's just that unconditional love that they show to folks.
Craig is an ecology, if you could say that, an ecosystem. And there are doctors here, there are nurses here, there are techs here, there are information people here, there are secretaries here, administrators, and so on, patients. And there are dogs here. And each of those things, I think, is a part of the Craig ecosystem. And they all contribute, but if you were to take any one of them away, Craig wouldn't be quite the same place that it is now.
We definitely could not do the pet therapy program here without all the wonderful volunteers that we have.
I love to share my dog, but I also love to try to inspire patients and help them understand that there are people out there that understand what they're going through, that have been there, and that life goes on and we change so much. We maybe redefine our life, but we're not changing who we are on the inside.
None of us as volunteers want anything from the program. I think each of us as volunteers want to see these kind of programs increase, to have dogs to meet every patient's needs as they come up.
I really miss my dogs, and getting to see them helps me.
Every size and shape of dog, so everything from a little tiny Maltese that weighs 6 pounds up to some of our big Newfoundlands, and Jack, who's a Italian sheepdog that weigh like 120, 160 pounds.
Jack doesn't care if your hand doesn't work the same way or what you're doing or how you do it. He just likes to say hi.
You're so sweet. For such a big mouth, you taste so gently.
And I see people from the beginning to the end get so much more confident and stronger, and how the dogs really encourage them through that time too.
It just makes it more feel like a more of a home environment. It brings something that they love at home, and that's a lot of times that's what they miss the most, is their animals.
The variety of breeds that we have, even the bird. I know that there are patients who have the bird card in their room, and they're very happy to have that little parakeet in their room. And so that animal has made a difference for a patient.
Best dog in the game right here.
Allie right now, who's a
hardest working dog in therapeutic visits.
A pit bull, and that's one comment that you always hear from a lot of the staff and patients alike. You know, well, that's what I have at home, you know, and I would love to meet Allie.
I think these dogs are part of the ecosystem of this hospital. If you took the dogs away, each of these dogs that come in, the ecosystem of Craig wouldn't be quite as strong.
So we're here, and Allie's a little stressed out. Maybe not as much as me, but watch out, bro. This is the leg that's got all the cancer in it.
we're going to remove, watch how sweet we go, the whole shoulder, the whole arm. I hope that takes care of her with a different diet and other treatment. X-rays and tests show it hasn't spread anywhere. It's just in her leg bone. So hopefully she'll live much longer. She is a wonderful companion. She has helped hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people. A pretty girl. She deserves a second chance, or a third chance, or a fourth chance. All right, well, just kind of a little update here. What do you hear, girl? And she didn't want to get out of the truck this morning after her experience yesterday with blood work and x-rays. And you know, she's never, not once, been left alone, so it's kind of concerning to me. I know she's going to be pretty stressed out. But next time we see her, this is going to be gone, and they're going to send it into a lab to get extensive testing on it. But she'll be okay. Yep, so there it is now, and hope she does well. All right, well, I'll keep you updated. Hey, can you shake again one more time? Okay, let me see it. Thank you. You look pretty sad. You look so sad. You're always happy. Can I have another one? Thank you. Yes. Can you smile? Huh? Can you smile? Say hi one more time. Yeah. She's not a happy camper. Yes. What about this one? We're not gonna make you put weight on that leg, okay? I know it hurts. Yeah, could you do a high five? Allie, could you do a high five? Yes. Okay. Can you smile? Can you smile? Smile. Allie, lay down. Come on, lay down. Good girl.
Yeah, this is so traumatizing to her. This thing, the bright lights, all these kennels, dogs barking, people she don't know being away from home. Poor thing. It's okay. Yeah, we'll get you home. So she wanted outside, and she finally stood up and went potty. A pretty girl. She's got her tail wagging. A pretty girl. So I gave her a couple pills. Come here, girl. Lay over. I rub your belly. Yes, I see that tail. Allie, you pretty girl. Allie. There you go. There goes the tail. She's getting her spirit back. Huh? Are you getting your spirit back? It is so weird not seeing her up running around. Anyway, I will continue with the updates. I want to thank everybody for the prayers and the shares and the contributions to help with her surgery and her recovery. I will do a video on that later. Definitely showing my gratitude. But she got up and went potty herself. But she was whining a little bit earlier, but she's, I got some pain pills in her, and
I won't let her near you, okay?
I think she's a little bit better. Yeah, now she's trying to get up. Oh, poor thing. I'm sorry, girl. Come on, pretty girl. Come on, girl. Let's come up here. Come on. You can do it. Come here, girl. Come on. She got her bandage off today. Come here, girl. Oh, you are that tired already? Come here, let's see. Come here, let's see. Let's get this off you, okay? Come here. Let's get it off. There you go. Come here, girl. Let's take a look at it. Well, there's the... What you think, girl, huh? You want some water? Let's get you in and get you some water, okay? Come on. Come on. So get her some water. Come on, girl. Let's see how you do it. Good girl, Allie. This is the first time she's been in here since she's been home. And look, who's here to greet us. That little butt. There's your buddy, Ruby. Are you a happy girl? Hmm? Oh, Allie. Come on, Ruby, are you so happy? Come say hi to your sister. Come on. Ruby, come say hi. Come say hi. Oh, she just wants to kiss me. Anyway, I think she's going to be better with... Ruby. Just knocked the phone out of my hand. That's water, girl. Anyway, so that bandage she had was pretty, probably pretty hot and uncomfortable. It was wrapped pretty tight. Come here, girl. There you go. Oh, did you wink at me? Did you guys see her wink? All right, Allie. It's a good girl. Well, this is just an update. Can't drink that. Come on. Hello, Ruby. Okay.
See, you did it. We gotta try this one more time.
Uncle Potty? I mean, I could be wrong, but her belly's gurgling and she's full, just, you know what I mean, like distended.
Well, she may have to go. She's. Can I pick you up, sweet girl?
She's gotta go
party. You're just
good girl, Mama.
She's a
well.
It's just maybe she's not gonna be able to walk.
I know. Good girl, baby. Yeah, I know she's gotta go. It's okay, baby. Good girl.
Let's just come over here out of the way. Let her do her thing.
Good girl. Go potty, Addy. Now we go potty.
Yeah, let's just go in a minute.
Yeah, it probably feels better. Her belly was all distended. I'm sure that hurts.
Yeah, you get these right here.
That's a different kind of cancer. That's not even the bone cancer. Yeah.
Okay.
She has a mastocytosis cancer. Thank you. She'll kiss you now.
Take a couple minutes, but like I said, even when it fully kicks in, she'll still know everyone's here.
That's Ruby. She's a rescue after.
Oh, wonderful.
That's Allie's sidekick.
Oh, is that right? So good, Mitch, to see you.
I don't want you to go. It's okay, Nana, it's not happening. Okay. I know. We talked about this, remember? Then she don't hurt no more, right? You don't want her to hurt no more. Okay, and it would only get worse, okay? This is better for her. It hurts us, but it's better for her, okay? So we're not going to be selfish, though.
Baby, did he give her a shot?
He gave her the shot that so she don't feel no pain. Okay, now she's.
Why she can't feel?
She don't hurt now at all. Okay, she's still awake. Her eyes are open. She can hear you. Okay.
But she can't feel anything.
She's just not feeling any hurt. Now she won't be hurt.
She won't be able to feel anything at all.
Okay. She's very relaxed. She's sleepy.
Can she feel anything right now?
No, but she can hear us. She knows that we're all still here. Okay? It's okay. Okay. And remember, everybody's here with her, so that's a good thing. Okay? She's not alone. She knows that everybody loved her. We ought to spend the whole day with her today. Right? It's okay, honey. She's just very relaxed, okay?
That's really a good thing. I mean, she's not feeling anything. So, like I said, this one is full-on anesthesia, and this is going to make sure she doesn't feel anything else.
Okay.
Can you just tell me?
That's the medicine that just like puts her to sleep. Okay. It'll be okay. She's not hurting. That's what's important. Okay. You know how bad she hurt today.
Thank you.
we don't want to hurt her. No.
He's gonna come out right here. Yeah. So I'm gonna lift her if you just wanna slide the pad.
It's okay. Perfect.
She's sleeping.
Honey, she's just out of it, can't you? She's just so, if you had surgery and that's what they would do, you would be out of it like that, okay? It's okay, okay? I understand.
God, this sucks.
You don't have to laugh at me.
Oh, it's okay.
You don't have to, okay?
I'm so sorry for you, bro.
But we don't want her to hurt no more, that's why, okay? And you guys remember how sad she was today. You know how bad she hurt today, okay?
And just know that her eyes won't close anymore.
It's okay, buddy. And you look how peaceful she is, though, right? I know, but she's peaceful, right? It's okay. Okay, listen. She's still with us. Hearing is the last thing to go, okay? Can he say goodbye to her too, Mike, when you're done? He just wants to say. See, she don't hurt no more, okay? I don't remember. I'm sorry. I can fill her pill bottle real quick.
Yeah, no worries. Is it okay if I have the ashes delivered there?
Yeah, or you can have them shipped here, either or. Last time I thought they just brought them to. Maybe. Did we pick them up or did they send them here?
I don't know.
I think they sent them here.
Okay,
I don't
know. You got it.
Do you want her to go in the blankie, or you want her to go, whatever you want, it's fine, I don't care, but...
Give me this.
Just so I have something to carry her with.
Can I have a stretcher if you want?
Do you want a stretcher instead? You'll just carry her? Ruby, do you want Ruby to come see her?
Yeah, Ruby, come here.
Come here, baby.
Come here, girl.
Hey, baby, Kanan, let yeah, Ruby let see Ruby her real Kanan. Quick, okay? So Ruby knows, okay?
Come here, Ruby.
No, you're fine.